Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and today we are going to discuss a lot of interesting questions of current affairs that can be of use in your phase one of RBI, SEBI and NABARD exams. So the very interesting topic that I'm going to discuss in this video, I can't wait to tell you, therefore I'm just giving you a brief introduction of that topic. So today we are going to discuss about the Sea Cow Conservation Reserve. Yes, cows are not only found on the land, but they are in the seas as well. So those who know what the sea cows are, they have already guessed what I am talking about. But those who don't know, let me tell you that sea cow is a type of fish in the sea. And what is it all about? What is the conservation and what are the things related to conservation that you need to take care of from the exam point of view? These are the questions that we will be discussing in this video. So let's begin. But before that, if you haven't subscribed, guys, then do subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification. And you can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and the link of this group is in description below. So here is the first question about the sea cow that I was talking about. So sea cow is a type of a species of fish which is officially known as dugong. Okay, so this is the official name of sea cow, but the unofficial name or the other name of dugong is sea cow, that you also need to know. So where will India's first dugong conservation reserve be established? Bay of Bengal, Andaman Sea, Lakadiv Sea, Palk Bay, Gulf of Kutch. The right answer is Palk Bay. So this is a strait between Tamil Nadu and Sri Lanka. And here, approximately in the area of 500 kilometers, this conservation reserve will be set up by the government of Tamil Nadu. Not only this area, but the Gulf of Mannar will also be covered. So that was all about this dugong conservation center that you need to know. Apart from this, you can just have a look at this cute sea cow. So this is the species that we were talking about. This is the sea cow. This is dugong. Now, you also need to know that it is an endangered marine mammal and it is facing an extinction. And even the closest species to this dugong species of fish has already been extinct in the 80s, in the times of 80s. And this is high time that conservation of these fishes needs to be taken up. Okay, so I have already explained these two points, that Gulf of Mannar and Palk Bay, both of these areas will be covered under this conservation center. Dugong is a sea mammal and the only living species of the order Sirenia. It is restricted to coastal habitat due to seagrass. So seagrass is the main food of this sea cow. So that was all about the conservation reserve that the Tamil Nadu government is going to set up. Next question is, recently the 6th Eastern Economic Forum was held between India and Russia at Vladivostok. The EEF is a platform for the discussion of key issues in the world economy, regional integration and development of new industrial and technological sectors, as well as of the global challenges facing Russia and other nations. The forum was established in 2015. Since then, it has been held every year. This year, it was held under the theme of opportunities for Far East in a world under transformation. At the forum, Indian companies, ONGC Videsh Limited and Indian Oil Corporation signed an MOU with a Russian company for cooperation in the hydrocarbon sector. Identify the second party to this MOU. So guys, this is your question. So recently, 6th Eastern Economic Forum took place between India and Russia, and this is the annual forum that takes place between India and Russia. And here the leaders of both the nations discuss issues that need cooperation from both sides. Okay, the very first thing from the question itself that you need to take care of is the year when this Eastern Economic Forum was launched. So it was launched in the year 2015 and it is held every year in the same city, that is Vladivostok. Okay, so it is held there. Now, this year's edition was held under the theme of opportunities for Far East in a world under transformation. And let me tell you that this year, India's delegation was led by the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, that is Hardeep Singh Puri, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed this forum virtually. So that was another additional information related to this Eastern Economic Forum. Now guys, here an MOU has been signed between Indian companies, Indian oil companies and Russian oil companies. So Indian oil companies are already mentioned in the question, but what is the name of the Russian company? So this is the question. So ONGC Videsh Limited and Indian Oil Corporation both have signed this MOU with Gazprom. So this is the Russian company with which these two Indian companies have signed an MOU for cooperation in the field of hydrocarbon sector. Okay. Now guys, I would like to ask a question from you. Can you guys tell me where is India's first hydrogen fuel plant is being established for mobility purpose? Okay. This is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Which state has launched Vatan Prem Yojana for gathering funds for its development projects? So this has been launched by Gujarat government. Now under this Vatan Prem Yojana, Vatan stands for nation, Prem is love, and Yojana is scheme. So basically, under this scheme, the non-resident Indians of Gujarati origin will be encouraged to invest in the development projects of their native villages so that the overall development will be promoted in the native villages of the NRI. Okay. NRIs of Gujarati origin. Okay. So do remember this thing. Now, the NRIs are supposed to invest 60% of the cost of the development project. For example, if we take the example of classrooms, developing or modernizing the classrooms of villages in Gujarat. So if that project is taken up, so the NRIs will have to invest 60% of the total project funding and 40% will be invested by the government of Gujarat. Okay, now I used the word have to, but there is no compulsion on the NRIs. It is just the welfare on the part of NRIs in the name of their patriotism. If they are patriotic and if they want to do something for their native country or their native place, then they can invest this much, and the limit for investment would be 60%. Okay, so that is this scheme all about. In order to gather funds from the diaspora of Gujarat, in the development projects, this scheme has been launched by the Gujarat government. Vijay Rupani is the CM of Gujarat. When was the first edition of Singapore-India Maritime Bilateral Exercise held? So basically, this is SIMBEX. Recently, 28th edition of this exercise took place in South China Sea. Okay, so this is the current news from where this question is coming up. Okay, so the first edition of this exercise was held in 1994, and this is the one of its kind exercise that has been running for a long period of time without any interruption. Basically, it has been running continuously. It has been conducted by both the governments, both the navies of Singapore and India continuously. Apart from this information, there is nothing much related to SIMBEX that you need to memorize. Now guys, if you remember that CCAT exercise, this year's edition of CCAT exercise was also taken place in Singapore. Basically, this was also a Navy exercise, but the Maritime Information Fusion Center located in Singapore provided the information input to the navies participating in the CCAT exercise. India was also a part of this exercise. So do remember this thing. That's why we say that Singapore was the venue of this exercise, because this Maritime Information Fusion Center located in Singapore was sharing the information, coordinating information with the navies participating in this exercise. Similarly, in the SIMPEX, both the India's Maritime Fusion Information Fusion Center, which is located in Gurugram, and this Singapore's Maritime Information Fusion Center were sharing information with each other. Okay, so that was all about this exercise. Next come, who has won the Behler Turtle Conservation Award 2021? So you have the five options, out of which Shailendra Singh from India has won this award for conservation of turtles. So he basically has contributed a lot towards the conservation of turtles because he has saved three species of turtles from going extinct. They were on the brink of extinction and this man contributed a lot towards conservation of those three species of turtle. So this demands us to have certain things, to know certain things about Shailendra Singh and about this award as well. So let's discuss that. So he's a biologist and he has been awarded this award. Now, first of all, related to this award, you need to know that this is also considered as a Nobel Prize in the field of turtle conservation. Okay. And the next point is that it was instituted in 2006 by these many organizations. Okay. Don't need to remember all the names of these organizations. This is just for your information purpose. The year of formation or institution of this award is 2006. So that was all about the award. Now let's know something about Shailendra Singh. So at present, there are at least 29 freshwater species of turtles and tortoises in India. And the species that he saved are these three. Northern River Terrapin, which are being conserved at the Sundarbans. Red-crowned roofed turtles, which are being conserved at Chambal. Black soft-shell turtles, which are being conserved at conserved in Assam. So these are the three species that he saved. Basically, he contributed a lot towards the conservation of these three species of turtles. Okay. So this is the last question. On whose death anniversary is the International Day of Charity observed? So the right answer is Mother Teresa. This day is observed on September 5. The National Teachers Day is also observed on September 5 in India. Okay, do remember. So Mother Teresa's death anniversary is on September 5th. And in order to acknowledge that, this International Day of Charity is observed worldwide. Her birth anniversary is August 26, 1910. So this is her birth anniversary. Now what is the theme of this day in 2021? Global solidarity to eradicate poverty is the theme. This is the theme of this day in 2021. Guys, Mother Teresa was known for her nursing. She has done a lot. She has given a lot of charity and also she has nursed a lot of injured and unhealthy people, sick people. Okay. So on that note, can you guys tell me who is known as the originator of nursing? Who is known as the mother of nursing? So this is your question that you have to tell in the comment section below. And on this note, our session ends. Thank you so much for watching it.